October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and usually it's women on the front lines of that fight, battling to inform others. But tonight, it's a Bay Area man on a mission.
As News Channel 8's Jennifer Lee explains, his reason for joining the crusade is deeply personal.
So I think I'm just going to trim the ends a little bit, for sure.
Paul Dombrowski is a guy who's likely to surprise you.
See what it does? It adds weight, and it'll just give it some control.
The Tampa hairdresser is in the latest chapter of a life story with lots of twists and turns. See, he hasn't always owned his own salon or been a slave to the flat iron.
Craig looking deep.
No!
Dombrowski intercepts!
No, Paul once made his living on the gridiron, playing over 6 years in the NFL for the Patriots, the Chiefs, and the Buccaneers.
Did you always know you wanted to play in the NFL?
No, not really. I wasn't one of those kids that just said, I'm going to be a football player, a fireman, and a hairdresser. And then I just worked that.
But here he is, sculpting a life few could have predicted, a life that recently took another very unexpected turn.
I'm sitting there watching TV, and I'm just kind of yawning. I went, what's that? So I felt a lump.
The son of parents who both had cancer knew immediately he had breast cancer. And in 2013, he entered another unexpected chapter.
I'm so used to locker rooms. I'm not used to being like serious about this stuff. You know, well, of course you're sitting in the waiting room. Apparently I'm the only guy here, right? So the secretary, nice and loud, Paul. Of course the other women are thinking they're gonna call Betty, Margaret, Paul. So here goes Paul to the back, right? I walk in the room, the nice pink apron laid out right there. Pink, how sexist is that?
He laughs now, but the diagnosis his doctor confirmed was incredibly serious.
Paul, your worst fears are realized. It's an invasive ductal carcinoma.
It's Dombrowski, who does an excellent job.
A guy who dished out hits as a defensive back in the NFL took a major blow from a cancer that rarely affects men. The National Breast Cancer Foundation says less than 1% of breast cancer cases develop in men, and only 1 in 1,000 men will ever be diagnosed with breast cancer.
It's my story.
It's why Paul is now breaking his silence, talking for the very first time with a message specifically to men.
Man up. I had to man up with breast cancer. I mean, you know, what more do you want here? You know, if you suspect something, you have to act on it.
You can do this. Don't be afraid.
It's the same message his wife of 31 years echoes. Carone Dombrowski recalls the day they renewed their wedding vows just weeks after learning about Paul's cancer.
And I remember just so deeply crying because I knew I loved him so much. And I know how you looked at me and we set our vows and videoed it. And I just knew, you know, he's got cancer right now. My gosh. And so now to be here in 2 years, it's like amazing. It's awesome. Thank you.
I think God has allowed things to happen in my life to put me here where I am now.
To prepare you for this.
Exactly.
Paula Carone, friends of ours, took a lot of courage for him to come out right there. So we applaud him for that. You need to know, according to the U.S. Cancer Society, there will be about 2,300 new cases of invasive breast cancer diagnosed in men this year. 440 men will die from it. Paul is only the second NFL player to ever publicly reveal that he battled breast cancer. Ernie Green of the Cleveland Browns also fought it and won.